A 1.5 meter tall boy is standing at some distance from a 30-meter tall building. The angle of elevation from his eyes to the top of the building increases from 30 degree to 60 degree. As he walks, towards the building, find the distance he walked towards the building. We have to draw the figure for it. Let us show 30-meter tall building as AB. And say 1.5-meter tall boy is at point C on the ground. We'll show him by a short line say CD, now CD is 1.5 meters. CD is 1.5 meters. He looks at this building AB's top. When he looks at the top of the building AB, the angle of elevation is 30 degree. The angle of elevation is 30 degree. The angle of elevation increases if boy walks towards the building. So this is direction of walking. Here you write AB is building CD is boy. If boy walks by some distance, say he comes here. Say his new position is C dash and D dash. After walking through some distance, say his new position is C dash. Right, and his height will be C dash D dash. C dash D dash will remain same because height of the boy will not change when he walks for a short distance. Only the position has changed here. From C to C dash, the boy has moved. And from here, if he looks at the top of the building, the angle of elevation becomes 60 degree. Angle has now increased. By how much distance the boy has walked, we have to find. That means C, C dash we have to find. So you can write here, C is 1 of boy. C dash is the position 2 of boy. Distance by which boy has walked is C, C dash. How do you calculate C, C dash? From figure, CC dash is equal to BC minus BC dash. Total distance minus distance between second position and foot of the tower. That means now we have to calculate what is BC and what is BC dash. Yes. Point. Newly drawn point it is. Will not be. Can call it as B dash. So from triangle ADB dash, I will be getting DB dash. From triangle A D dash B dash, I will be getting D dash B dash. Is there any relation between DB dash and CB? Are they not equal? Yes, because it forms a rectangle here, 1.5 meter, 1.5 meter, and here you are having 90 degree. Is it right? So this DC BB dash will become a rectangle. Therefore, opposite sides will be equal. That means BC will be equal to B dash D. So that you can write here. DB dash is equal to BC. Now, right, from triangle ADB dash, I know opposite side. I want to calculate adjacent side. Which trigonometric ratio should I use? Opposite side, adjacent side relating trigonometric ratio will make use of cot. We will make use of cot. Yes. You write for cot 30. Cot 30 is equal to B dash D upon AB dash adjacent side upon opposite side. What is cot 30? Root 3. B dash D, we have to calculate. AB dash is 28.5 meter. 28.5 meter. So I got B dash D equal to 28.5 into root 3 meters. Now in triangle, which triangle you have to consider? A, D dash, B dash. Cot 60° equal to D dash, B dash upon AB dash. Cot 60 is D dash B dash by AB dash. So 1 by root 3 equal to B dash D dash upon AB dash. 1 by root 3 equal to B dash D dash upon (28.5 meters). So B dash D dash will become equal to 28.5 divided by 3 meters. Therefore, C C dash equal to 3 minus B C dash, that is equal to 3 dash D minus 3 dash D dash. Here you can write, since BC equal to B dash D and BC dash equal to B dash D dash. Now subtract. (28.5 × √3 − 28.5/√3 meters). You can take LCM and simplify. You have to multiply and divide first term by root 3. So taking LCM, we are having root 3 in denominator. So it will be 28.5 into 3 minus 28.5 divided by root 3. Subtracting, you will get 2 times 28.5 upon root 3. 57 upon root 3. Nineteen threes are 57. So you can cancel this root 3 with 3, which gives you coefficient root 3. So 19 root 3 meters. 19 root 3 meters is the distance by which the boy has walked. The boy has walked through 19 root 3 meters. 19 root 3 meters.